Hello everybody, welcome to my first YouTube tutorial. I'm going to do some 3D letters. I just did a tutorial, but I'm totally new to YouTube, producing something on YouTube. And I didn't know it could be only 15 minutes, so I just did this one. The video was too long and I didn't want to cut it up, it really looked strange, so I'm going to start again. Not with such a big piece, this took me like half an hour. And I'll just do a small word again to post on YouTube, just as a tutorial. It doesn't need to be this big. It's kind of boring to see me do five letters all the same. So I'm going to make a short word, just hi. Doesn't matter what word. Here we go. Just starting with a pencil, ordinary cheap pencil from any store. I think it's HB, but I don't know. It doesn't even say it. I'll just sketching, and first I'll just write the word I wanted to do. I'm going to do hi. What I want to do is, I'm going to make this a capital letter because I think I like the way I want to do letters that have some curls on the end, are small on the top, and become bigger in the bottom, like this. It's an H, so this needs to go all the way here. Going to be pretty big age, but I think that's fine. So I want some big, bold lower parts, and like this. So I'm sketching, I'm really not pushing my pencil very hard, just really lightly, so, because I want to erase this in a second. I'll trace it with a pen when I'm done. Now this can be a bit bigger. Also, my eraser is from like 23 euro cents from, I'm probably not pronouncing this right, but Sostrene Grene. Also the pencil, and I really like this eraser particularly. The pencil is just, well, but the eraser is pretty soft and cheap, so I have quite a lot. This is my H, and I'll do an I, more simple. No, the bottom should be bigger. Here we go. This will be it. So now I'm tracing these lines with my Pigma Micron 08. It's a pretty big pen, not very fine, but I like that. I want it to be kind of bold. So as you probably can hear, I'm not a native English speaker. Kind of in doubt what to do with this YouTube channel I'm new on. I did quite some live videos on Instagram, but I think it feels like such a waste. They disappear after 24 hours. So that's why I'm starting this YouTube channel. I'm doing this in English as a non-native speaker, so if you prefer me to do videos in Dutch or in English, if you like it that way, please let me know for the next video. This one will be in English. I'll do my best, but sometimes it might sound strange. Okay, the biggest challenge for me is patience. Now, I want to erase, and I know it won't be completely dry yet. I'll just use my heater tool real quick. I have so many smudged drawings. Okay, erasing the... Okay, my table is a little bit wobbly. Sorry for the camera shaking. Okay. Done. What I will do now is pick some Tombow colors and let's see, I can use the same ones as I did over here. Let's do that. Those are these three colors, all Tombow Dual brush pens. Number 055, 093, and 373. It will be the lightest color on the top, and I'll blend them later, darker to the bottom. So, first that yellow. So, there are some kind of imaginary lines. I'll just draw them next to the letters. so I can erase them in a minute. So I'll put my yellow, well, more or less up till this first line. Then there will be the light green between these lines. And I do want a little bit of green here, because otherwise not much happening here. So that doesn't have to be really precise or anything. It's just to give an indication where you want your color and to create a consistent drawing. And then the darkest color. As you can see, I'm not doing the entire letters. This is watercolor paper, just cheap watercolor paper by the Flying Tiger Productions. I like it, it's pretty, it has quite some texture. Okay, I need to fill my koi water brush real quick. So what I'm doing, I'm having some toilet paper next to me just to wetten the brush. And I always start with, I always cover up all the color. So this one, this yellow on top, doesn't need to be blended. But I think it looks more even when I make it wet too. So, and then I start blending into the dark, a little bit darker color. Not much of a color difference between this yellow and this green though. But. So, and what happens when you water it, so the lines you get, because you cover it twice sometimes with the pen, gets more even and, in my opinion, more beautiful. So I always go over all the color, and there comes the real blending. Just first the boundary, kind of the boundary between the two colors, blend that one. Then clean my water brush on the toilet paper and blending the lighter color, cleaning, blending, and going more up after every clean, and then going down to make sure if you don't wet the entire color, you will see the difference in a minute. Make sure your water brush is nice and wet, because if it is kind of dry, it will ruin your paper. So, next part. Oh, I hope this is already 7 minutes, so I'm hoping this word is short enough for a YouTube video within 15 minutes.
I'll do my best.
Yellow. Green. Blue-green. Turquoise. You can do this with any letter, by the way. I'm going to make this 3D, and you can use any font, every letter you want to write, and apply the same techniques to it. It won't make a difference. So, cleaning this, cleaning and wetting my brush for this part. So, oops. Because this is watercolor paper, it blends really easily. Normal paper, the pen dries the ink. Oops. Okay, so I'm feeling a little bit rushed now, I think, so I'm making mistakes. You can do this better than I can.
Yes, you can.
Some yellow, just a little bit on the top. The dot will be all yellow. Green. This needs to be all green, it's all between those
lines, but I will put a little bit of
blue-green on the bottom.
Like this, just to give a little bit more happening.
Wetting and cleaning my brush, starting on the top and working my way down. And how quicker you get to blending the colors, the better it will look. So that's why I don't color in all the letters all at once.
So I'm going to use my healer tool again, sorry for the noise. to make a white line, outline it again. I'm going to do this pretty big. On my Instagram you can see examples where I did those lines a little bit smaller, thinner. I'm going to do a little bit big and bold today. So let's try to get them. Yep. So I'm trying to do this consistently, like everywhere about the same size. That never really is perfect, but that's fine with me. I think there will be some space over here, like this. Sometimes it's just like, okay, let's see what looks good. Also here. That's that. Let's erase these lines. Ooh, no smudging, please. Thank you. These bother me, and these lines are bothering me. Okay. So first, what I'm going to do is use my black Tombow and 15, keeping this all in the same angle all the time. Over here, no, won't do that. My light will be over here. Won't do that because it will be on top of the white. No, no, no. Okay, here it gets underneath the white. So I'll just keeping it in this angle. Oh, creating the shading. Oops, this is not so clear. Taking a micron, covering this up a bit.
Oh, too bad. But this is what happens to me all the time.
On down, no, not over here because it will be on top of the white outline, but there will be shading over here, like this. Keeping the same angle more or less, this will be all the way here. And you can use your brush pen for this very easily. This will be all black. Very small, I shouldn't be using the brush pen for this thing.
And to create some extra depth, I'm also using my gray N65
and going over this black quite quickly in the same angle, sometimes going twice to make it look like there's some blending too. Here you go, and then some even lighter Tombow color N95, one of my favorite pens to blend because it's so light. You don't have to work really clean, but it does give an effect with almost every letter you use.
Okay, now I want to do something in here too. Let's use my pencil sign brush and hurry because time's ticking. So light is over here. I want this color to look like it's more down, so there will be shading on the top and on the bottom. So I'll just go here, then make it disappear. Left and on the top. Make it disappear. Should be all the way there. Like this. Always the left lines and on the bottom. Trying not to forget parts, but maybe you can always do that later, so that doesn't really matter if you forget something. Top and on the left, this is too far, but no, not really bothering. So this was my first tutorial. Here we go. Hi, nice to meet you all. So my Instagram is this one. Nice to see you there. Have a nice day. Bye bye.